33 cars came here looking to qualify for the race, however only 20 made it through. Todd Stater takes the pole position after a great win at Daytona. Rick Forrest starts in second place. Stanley Parsons and Monica Rook share row number 2. Tyron Key and Kenny George III in row number three. Row number 4 has Kelly Splyson and Chuck Johnson, Kevin Monroe and Billy Ray Smith Thompson qualifying 9th and 10th. Leslie Riggs and Ashley Tucker made it in on the time on the qualifying races, just like Trey Ashby and Dan Lecklider, Bob Steffens and Sarah Wexler, Gio Arias and John Burr, and Jim Kidd and Zach Gott bring the rear of the field. Drivers that did not qualify were Bradley Carlisle, Troy Peterson, Harv Henry, Billy Bob Childress, surprisingly enough, Danica Holofield and Kirby Krieger, Carlos Pavito, Zach Webster, Maury and Honey Holter, Lev Azaroff, also a big surprise, Todd Lacey and Tom Brato. Now, let's go down trackside. I am down to the green, Todd Stater. He has a terrible start. Rick Forrest capitalizes it. Stanley Parsons also misses his cue. And there goes Monica Rook, trying to go for second place. At the end of the first lap, Rick Forrest continues to lead. And he opens a bit of a cushion, but it's not enough. Stater trying to make that move. Stanley Parsons in the back of Todd Stater. Stater does not take that nicely. Shows him a one-finger salute. And there goes by Stater. Tyron Key starting in third, started in fifth place, goes now for third position. Monica Rook starting to fall back through the field. She gets tagged by Billy Ray Smith Thompson hard into the wall. And she is done for the day. That's the first caution of the night. Leading him down to the green is Rick Forrest. And there you see the whole field going, attacking the line as there goes Kelly Splyson in the back of Chuck Johnson, Kenny George in the third, and Jim can't get together. And that's the second caution right after the restart. And as you see, Zach Gott, and I believe that is Sarah Wexler, they head into the pits. Rick Forrest leads him down to the green. Todd Stater running second, Tyron Key running third place. Fourth place is Telly Parsons as Chuck Johnson gets into the back of Kevin Monroe. And that's another caution right after the restart. Dan Lecklider got involved in a collision under caution, heads into the pits, and will be back on the and will be on the rear of the pack. Zach got one lap down, just like Kelly Splyson and Sarah Wexler. Green flag is in the air, Rick Forrest continues to lead. And now there you see Stanley Parsons going on the inside. John Burr gets tagged by Gio Arias. And that's another caution. Burr is done for the day. Arias suffers from a problem under caution. He's gonna stop on track and will merge back one lap before the green flag. So that's karmic contribution. Forrest continues to lead. There's contact. Jim Kidd into the back of Rick Forrest. Kelly Splyson trying to recover her lap, just like Zach Gott. There's contact. Todd Stater gets tagged by Gio Arias. He goes around for a second, saves it. No caution. And there you see, there goes Kelly Splyson and Sarah Wexler around Rick Forrest. And there's a battle in Rick Forrest into the outside wall after contact between Sarah Wexler and Kelly Splyson. He's going to be on the back of the pack. And Trey Ashby now merges back on track after having problems under caution. He has to take off the hood. And now Tyron Key takes the lead from Stanley Parsons on the inside. There he goes. And he takes it the lead. Sarah Wexler now passes Zach Gott. Both, if they maintain their current situation, Wexler is back on the lead lap. Zach Gott's back one lap down, and he's only one lap away from being back in the running. Same with Gio Arias making the move around Tyron Key. Stanley Parsons now takes the lead from Tyron Key. Jim Kidd now running third place. Ashley Tucker running at the top 10, having a good run. Actually running in the top 5, 4th place. There she goes inside of Jim Kidd together with Dan Lecklider. Lecklider now in the top 5. At the current moment, Zach Gott also and Gio Arias pulling away. Tyron Key fighting back with Stanley Parsons. Parsons, big run on the outside. He's going to keep the lead away. Jim Kidd now running in 5th place, dropping position by position. Billy Ray Smith Thompson looking to break into the top 5. And there goes Smith Thompson on the inside, and Jim Kidd blows up. Problems for Jim Kidd. I don't think he blew up, but problems for Jim Kidd. He stops on the track. Another caution. And as you see, Sarah Wexler, Zach Gott, Gio Arias are back on the lead lap. Jim Kidd now heads into the pits. Gio Arias heads into the pits once again. Same with Leslie Riggs. Bob Steffens also into the pit road. Problems for him as well. Sarah Wexler Now as you see the restart, she's on the back of the pack together with Bob Steffens and Ellie Riggs. Both had to take the front end of their cars off, and Bob Steffens around! Another caution! And problems, Todd Stater stopped the track, he hit the wall coming out of the pits, and Kelly Splasso is back on the lead lap, that's a good thing, I think. Ashby is also back on the lead lap. Stanley Parsons leads him down to the green. Second place is still Tyron Key. Ashley Tucker running third place. She gets it to the back of Tyron Key. Joe Arias loses it alone. And that's another caution. Kevin Monroe also with a bit of problems without his front hood. Leading the field to the green is Stanley Parsons. And he hits the wall properly in turn number two. There goes Tyron Key on the inside. Three wide. Kenny George the third. Then Lecklider fighting for position. Chuck Johnson also is in this mess. And now three wide, Key on the inside, Joe Arias on the inside, pushing up! And there's contact! Contact between Joe Arias and Tyron Key. Another caution as you go on board with Kenny George the third. There you see, right in front of the whole field, and then Lecklider just barely misses it as you go on board with him. Joe Arias just pushes up into Key, and there goes Lecklider on the inside, avoiding everybody. That's a lot of luck if you told me. And as you're gonna see, Zach Gott now running in second place, Todd Stater in third, Sarah Wexler running in the battle for the win, Billy Ray Smith-Thompson heads into the pit road. Leading him down, Lecklider has a mostly undamaged car. There's contact, Tyron Key around, no caution. Stanley Parsons in the back of Tyron Key. I don't know if that was retaliation or something, or if Stanley Parsons is just dumb, but that happened. That had just happened. And see Zach Gott now fighting for third place. Todd Stater just went around him. I actually am mistaken. I don't think Todd Stater is on the lead lap anymore. I'm not sure. Short track racing is a big mess anyway. Kevin Monroe breaking into the top 5. Bob Steffens having a great run. He's trying to challenge for Lecklider's lead at the current moment. In the meantime, Lecklider starts to open a big difference over the rest of the field. And Kenny George the third broke, stops on track. Another yellow flag. Ashley Tucker has problems under caution, heads into the pit road. Not a good result. Green flag for Daniel Lecklider, he leads. Second place is Bob Steffens, and Todd Stater is indeed. One lap down, I was missed. The contact! Rick Forrest into the back of Kevin Monroe, into Kenny George the third. Monroe saves it. Rick Forrest, buddy in the middle, and that's gonna work somehow. Nobody's chilling, it's a short track race. Mind your time. Joe Arias beating and banging going into turn number 3. Kelly Splice emerging back on track. It's a big cluster. Oh my god. And there goes Leslie Riggs trying to rejoin the top 10. There she goes on the inside. Kevin Monroe still on the middle. Kenny George the third. And now Chuck Johnson with problems heads into the pit road. Not a good run for big Chuck Johnson. And as you see the onboard camera off, Bob Steffens trying to catch up to Lecklider the fastest he can. Because if you stay at the front, they're probably not going to kill you in the middle of the race. And now Zach Gott trying to make a move. He's running in third place. Fantastic run for Zach Gott. Leslie Riggs also running in the top 5. She actually took third position from Zach Gott. Stanley Parsons into the back of Leslie Riggs. In the meantime, Daniel Lecklider starts running over the lapped cars. First car to be lapped, it's Todd Stater. He has a lot of damage. The race has not been kind to the Daytona winner in pole position. And Lecklider is getting held up a little bit. Bob Steffens starting to catch up as Lecklider just goes around Stater. Leslie Riggs running third. And now Lecklider is going to run over Sarah Wexler and Kenny George the third. Sarah Wexler, the last car on the lead lap. She is still in the top 10 though, this shows how much the field has spread it out. And battle for third place between Leslie Riggs and Stanley Parsons. Parsons is going to win that out easily. Leslie Riggs just trying to maintain the position. She's actually being promoting the Albuquerque Speedway, the next race on the FARC calendar. as Gavin Monroe maintaining his top 5 positioning, Tyron Key running 7th place right behind Rick Forrest. 8th place is Billy Ray's Matt Thompson, having a good run, not the best of his life. And as you see, Lecklider getting held up by the lap car of Kenny George III. This might help Bob Stephens a lot. As Sarah Wexler just goes around Lecklider, she just does not want to go one lap down. Stanley Parsons on the inside of Bob Stephens, going for the second position. Stephens on the wall! And there goes Stanley Parsons for the second place, and he's catching up to Lecklider. He's just way too fast. And there goes Wexler, now got lapped by Lecklider, and she's making a bit of padding the gap between Lecklider and Parsons as Lecklider cannot go around Kenny George III. Kenny George has just been a concrete wall. Oh, there goes Wexler to ruin Lecklider's race on the inside of the number 10. And she's gonna make it through, and now this puts Lecklider on the claws of Stanley Parsons. Parsons in that angle be on the inside of Lecklider's Leonard. And there goes Stanley Parsons for the lead of the race. And he probably laps Sarah Wexler and is going after Kenny George III. He goes around Kenny George III, and now he has Trey Ashby to go through. But Lecklider does not want to lose this race. He just fights back, and we're not even on the halfway point of this race, mind you. And now Lecklider on the inside of Stanley Parsons, capitalizing on the bit of a squirrely move by Parsons. Lecklider back on the lead. Kelly Spicer on the back of Todd Staler. Staler into the wall pretty hard. And as you go on board with Staler, he gets shafted into the wall, tries to save the car, but it's not enough. He hits that wall head on. He's done for the day. Rick Forrest with problems coming to the caution. Not a good race for Rick Forrest. Green flag for Dan Lecklider. Oh, close contact! Gio Arias into the pit wall! Big contact! As Stanley Parsons tried to go around Dan Lecklider, we're gonna catch up what happened to Gio Arias, and I think Leslie Riggs, as Stanley Parsons takes the lead of the race. Leslie Riggs is running third place. Gio Arias just pushes into her, sends her into the pit road and into the pit wall. I don't know what Gio Arias is thinking, that freaking clownfish, but he just screwed over Leslie Riggs. And there's no caution whatsoever. Billy Ray's Matt Thompson, contact! Contact, even more contact. What the hell are these people thinking? Leslie Riggs now merges back on track. She changed tires, mind you. Her tires were dirty. She chose to change the right side tires. This might help her big time. Caution's out. Because of this. It's Stanley Parsons. Problems for Stanley Parsons. He's going to lose multiple laps on the pits. I don't know what happened to him, but he's going to still be on the pits as the green flag flies with Billy Ray Smith Thompson on the lead. Second place is Dan Lecklider. Third place is Zach Gott. Fourth is Bob Stephens. Fifth, Kevin Monroe. And Trey Ashby closes the cars on the lead lap. Leslie Riggs just restarted behind Kelly Splice and Kenny George III. She is faster than both, and she's trying to recover her lap, recover one lap from Billy Ray Smith Thompson, and she's trying to make it on a three wide. Look out, look out, look out. There she goes. And she is not coming down. She's already gonna go around Kenny George III, and she's gonna be one lap down at this point, and she is faster than the whole field, surprisingly enough. Maybe the tires have something. Maybe it's Maybelline. I don't know. As Billy Ray Smith Thompson continues to lead. Lecklider right on him as the lap cars start to go around him. Lecklider now having a look on the inside of the number 2 as Leslie Riggs continues to pull away. Zach Gott is the next car to her, I believe, that she needs to unlap herself from. Stanley Parsons now running 6 laps down. This is the worst thing that could happen to the man. As Zach Gott running in third place now, trying to go around the 7 off Bob Stephens, but it's not enough. He will have to try later on. As Stephens running second place, he finished third in the championship last year. Maybe this can be his year. Maybe, I don't know. I don't think he actually ever won a FARC race in his whole career, and his career is like, what, 10 years at this point? That's something, I'm not gonna lie. As Leslie Riggs now goes by the cars that will be lapped in like 30 laps or so, she goes by Trey Ashby, and she is fighting to get back on the lead lap. As Bob Stephens now has a look on Billy Ray Smith-Thompson, catching up to him, the leaders are under a blanket. It's Ray Smith-Thompson, Bob Stephens and Zach Leiter running on 2-3. And as you see, Leslie Riggs is right behind the Zach Gott. Zach Gott and Kenny George the third, so if she passes those two, she can actually catch up to the leaders, unlap herself, and she's back on the race under green flag condition. What if she wins this race? Then I'll give up on all my faith, because what the hell, man? As Riggs goes by Chuck Johnson, now she only has the leaders to go by as Lecklider goes on the inside off Bob Stephens. The fact that they're running side by side also helps Riggs a lot. And there she goes on the inside of Bob Stephens. And now Lecklider. And she's gonna go by Lecklider. No problems there. There she goes by him. Bye bye. And she only has now Billy Ray Smith-Thompson to go around through. And you go on board with her. And he is getting held up by Kelly Splicen. And Leslie Riggs trying to have a look. And there goes Riggs. Riggs is now gonna be in 7th place. She only has 6 more cars to pass to win this race. As Smith-Thompson wants to put her back one lap down, but he can't quite do it. Riggs is just way too fast. And there goes Riggs. Riggs run away. Oh, she hit the wall. She hit the wall. Smith-Thompson tried to capitalize. And nope. And then Lecklider hits the wall, but he's still faster than Billy Ray Smith-Thompson. And that may help Lecklider in the long run, because Smith-Thompson's not having a lot of one of his best races. Although he is leading, this is not one of his best races. Zach Gott running 4th place, Kevin Monroe running 5th, as Bob Stephens runs in 3rd. 6th, I believe, is Tyron Key still. As Leslie Riggs runs in 7th place, she goes by Kevin Monroe for 6th, and is looking to go by Tyron Key for 7th. And there she goes, for 6th, and there she goes. For 5th, she's now on the top 5, and we are under 50 laps to go, so this may not end well. We're under actually 20 laps to go, I believe, at this point. And Leslie Riggs around Zach Gott for the 4th position. She is now on the top 5 safely as Billy Ray Smith-Thompson into the wall. Lecklider is right on him. And now this is going to be a battle for the lead as Lecklider is right on Billy Ray Smith-Thompson. 3rd place is still Bob Stephens trying to capitalize, because if those two on the front crash, Stephens may actually luck out and win this race. As she goes by Stanley Parsons, Zach Gott still running well. He is the 5th car. He is in 5th place and about to get lapped. We might end up this race with only 4 cars on the lead lap, depending if Leslie Riggs gets lapped or not. As Lecklider now has a look, as Billy Ray Smith-Thompson has to go by Trey Ashby, but Lecklider is losing a lot of time in the turns. And now there goes Leslie Riggs on the inside of Bob Stephens for the 3rd position, and you can see Lecklider and Billy Ray Smith-Thompson are right there, and look at Leslie Riggs already on the back of the number 10. Leslie Riggs is in contention for this one. And look at Leslie Riggs on the inside of Lecklider. Less than 15 laps to go, and look at her on the inside of Billy Ray Smith-Thompson having a look, and there she goes to take the lead. Only 10 laps remain here at Sayre, and well, Leslie Riggs just took the lead and tried to pull away, and I think she's actually going to be able to win this race. If she does, this is the hijack of the century, because somehow, some way, she recovered 2 laps under green flag after getting spun out. And now she has a look on Zach Gott trying to lap him. And Zach Gott is going to try to put some resistance, finish on the lead lap, at least for honor. Because he has had a great run, started in last, is running in 5th. Lecklider goes by Billy Ray Smith-Thompson in the closing stages to take the 2nd position, but he's just way too far behind. Just way, way, way too far behind, as Leslie Riggs goes by Zach Gott to put only 4 cars on the lead lap. And around four cars will finish on the lead lap at the end of this race with two laps to go. White flags in the air for Leslie Riggs. She came from all the way back in I believe 11th place, and she's gonna round out the final quarter to take the win here at Sayre after being two laps down. Leslie Riggs stole the lead from Billy Ray Smith-Thompson with 9 laps to go, never looked back. Dan Lecklider has to settle for second after leading the most laps with 67. Bob Steffens finishes up in 4th place. 5th place, the first car 1 lap down was Zach Gott. Kelly Splyson, also 1 lap down, finishes up in 6th place. Kevin Monroe, 7th place, was in 5th at one point. Tyron Key led 7 laps. The rookie finishes up in 8th place after starting in 5th. Trey Ashby works his way from 13th to 9th place. Sarah Wexler started in 16th, has to settle for 10th place 3 laps down. Kenny George III, 5 laps down in 11th. Stanley Parsons, 12th place, 6 laps down. Chuck Johnson still ran to the finish, but he had so many problems he ended up 26 laps down. The last car running. Rick Forrest, Gio Arias, Todd Stater, Ashley Tucker, Jim Kidd, and John Burr, also Monica Rook, did not complete the race. Championship standing, see Todd Stater open the gap over Monica Rook, although both failed to finish. Stanley Parsons with his 12th result finds himself in 3rd. Leslie Riggs with her win joins Stater and Kenny George III, who is 5th in the standings in the FARC off. Kevin Monroe is 6th place, Ashley Tucker 7th, so it's a good situation for the M&J racing cars at the current moment. Dan Lecklider 8th place, Richard Scott still sitting on his Daytona results. We do not know if he starts any other races, but if he still keeps himself in the top 40, I believe he is on the FARC off still. Jason Bates is 10th, left Azarov 11th after failing to qualify. Billy Ray Smith-Thompson 12th, Riley Derby 13th, Bob Steffens 14th, Liam O'Connor 15th, Ellie Riggs 16th in the Bjorn Green car, Robert Lecklider, Kenny Brillen, Kelly Splyson, and Thomas Tucker close the top 20. The next time FARC gets into action will be at the Albuquerque Speedway in New Mexico.